Morning, good afternoon, and good evening to you all, and thank you for joining. As I mentioned, my name is Ria, and I lead the Sourcing and Procurement Center of Excellence at Infosys. Hope you are all keeping safe, and I guess most of you would be joining from the comfort of your homes today. So today's session, I hope you will find it interesting. Today's session, we have thought this through because of certain inputs that we've been receiving from majority of our clients and many companies across the globe. They have reported supply chain challenges and supply disruptions due to current COVID-19 situation. In today's webinar, we will be sharing details about the Rapid Risk and Disruption Assessment Service, which has been launched by Infosys as a free service to offer our support. Before we move forward, let me share some details about today's session with you. All participants are on only, and if you, however, you will have an opportunity to ask questions towards the end of the session. We will be taking, you can raise your hand and we will unmute you and you can ask your questions. For people who are joining through the phone, if they are not able to find that hand, the raising hand option, they can send us a note to the Q&A box that you see on the right of your screen, and we will be able to unmute you and you can ask. Alternatively, you can also send in your questions through the Q&A box. We also have lined up a few polls for this session, which will again appear on the right side of your screen. So before we move ahead, let me introduce the host for today and the speaker for today, which is Chris, who is the Global Practice Head for Sourcing and Procurement Services for Infosys. He comes with 30 years of experience with very detailed experience across manufacturing, consulting, and EPC companies. Chris has been one of the pioneers and visionaries behind the next generation procurement solutions. And let me, not waste any further time and hand over to Chris for taking us through the session. Over to you, Chris.
Thank you, Ria. For those of you who are wondering why the picture on the slide and what you see on the video is different, is because I'm sporting the lockdown look. So there's a slight difference between the picture and what you see. So, before we get into what is the agenda of the day and what we are going to present to you today, a quick background in terms of, for those who may not be aware, a quick background of what we do in Infosys Procurement Services, what kind of services do we provide, what is the length and breadth, and as well as how many clients do we address, and so on. So we have about 2,500 plus sourcing and procurement professionals, which includes category managers, sourcing analysts, supply market analysts, and of course, P2P analysts as well. This 2,500 does not include AP, accounts payable, which in the Infosys scheme of things falls under finance and accounting. Just as a footnote, I wanted to mention that. So what do these 2,500 people do? So we provide category management services, strategic sourcing support, contract management, procure to pay, advanced analytics, and we also do supply market intelligence for several of our clients. And that's also a service that we will be talking briefly about as a part of the risk assessment service that we are going to do a deep dive into today. So, we address about 120 plus global clients in multiple languages around the globe, like several other service providers as well. In terms of the, from a spend perspective, we process in terms of different kinds of modes. So there is end-to-end spend that we manage, there is spend that we analyze and identify opportunities, and as well as spend that we manage the procure to pay part of the offering. So as a part of the service, we also bring savings to the bottom line of our clients. And you see some numbers there in terms of what kind of savings we have been able to bring about for our clients. We also have several digital procurement solutions. As we know that most of the procurement organizations are moving towards digitalization of procurement, all digital procurement, as it is being called. So we have our own IP over several niche procurement digitalization products and platforms that we have built, which of course we will address in maybe some of the upcoming webinars that we will be bringing to all of you. So with that brief and quick overview about Infosys, so that you have the right background as to who we are and where are we coming from in terms of the service that we are talking about today. So the agenda for today, what is the quick overview in terms of what challenges and what companies are looking at today and in the near future in the upcoming 3 to 6 months. We have tried to make an estimate about that. And then a deep dive into the specific service that we are talking about, which is geared towards the immediate needs of what an organization needs to meet the situation as we face today. And then we will also do a quick summary about the other crisis management solutions that Infosys brings to organization. Okay, so let's look at what are the typical challenges and you know, the situation that the organizations are facing. But before that, we thought that we would also hear from you in terms of what has been the impact to your organization's supply chain and are your so there is a quick poll which is coming up, and you can choose any of the options in terms of A, B, C, D, and E, and which basically covers in terms of, so it's a short poll, shouldn't take you more than 30 seconds to complete. So whether it is in terms of minor disruptions only in the short term, or it could be a mix that some locations are seeing higher impact. That is what we are seeing with several of our clients as well. And there is higher impact in some locations and low to medium in some of the others. But there are several organizations which have a manufacturing or supply locations from only some of the impacted countries or regions, and they are seeing major difficulties to continue production or to meet targets. And excuse me. And the other thing is that organization, this situation is changing on a weekly basis, and sometimes probably shorter than that as well. So organizations are finding it, you know, it may not be a static position that, you know, the impact is known today. Okay. I'm hoping all of you have been able to respond to the poll. And hopefully you didn't have any technology challenges in doing that. So let's see if we are able to make an assessment in terms of what has been the impact amongst the participants today. Or yeah, we can come back to it in a bit.
Sure.
Yeah, so let's keep moving forward. So let's see that, as we said, that what has the pandemic, what kind of impact it is having. And I think you all would be reading about this, so I don't really want to, you know, re-emphasize that in terms of the impact, whether it is in terms of the per capita income, the job losses that are predicted to happen in terms of the output. So all of us know that I think in most organizations, there is going to be an impact in terms of business that all of us are engaged in. Yeah. So, and as the even the survey says, which has been done by ISM, that 75% of the companies expect some disruption or the other. Right. So with that background, let's see what is it that is needed to meet that kind of a disruption and how organizations would be looking at in the short to medium time frame. Okay, we can move forward. Yeah, so typically we have broken down this into, say, three stages. And of course, some of the stages could be different for different organizations. So this is a generic kind of representation. So the first would be in terms of to respond to the crisis and to stabilize in terms of either restoring the supplies from suppliers and to bring back full capacity, look at how the risk is in terms of the future, the immediate future in the coming weeks and months. And also, there is a cash flow element to it, right? So suppliers need to be paid. And considering that certain governments have even passed legislation or regulatory notices to the effect that the small and medium enterprises, the payments cannot be delayed. So organizations need to be aware of either the regulatory requirements and as well as in terms of what which prioritize and which to pay when. So, and this needs to be almost on a daily basis or on a weekly basis that visibility is required. Right? There could be a couple of other based on the organization's requirements. Okay. And then post that, once the immediate, you know, say the crisis response has been managed, there is also how to manage the spend in the 3 to 6 months time frame that we are looking at. Right? So from now till about 3 months and going beyond, so working capital, rationalizing payment terms, what are the rebound strategies, so finding alternate suppliers and tying up with them. Some you may have, you may be required to do immediately, but then there could be larger contracts, etc., which need to be redrawn and with the with alternative suppliers as well across the globe, right? And maintaining production. Post that, and as well as a follow-up to that, there is also about moving to the new normal, right? So what would new normal mean? There are several organizations which have dependencies of suppliers being only in one location. So probably those are, the new normal would be that at all times you would have, even though that may be at an extra cost, you will have suppliers in alternative locations as well. To de-risk and the over-dependence on a particular location or region. Yeah. So supply chain, and this has to be dynamic as well. So there has to be more agility in the procurement function as well and the supply chain function as well to look at how dynamically it can change. So we have seen that even in the last 2 to 3 weeks, most of the procurement organizations have been forced to keep changing their strategy, and even the work that we have been doing on behalf of our clients, we've had to be very agile about it in terms of moving a huge workforce suddenly to work from home, and as well as, you know, to give you one example, we tied up with a supplier in India to supply about 1 million masks for China. This was about end of January, and this was, and one day before the shipment was to go out, the Indian government stipulated that all exports of PPE are prohibited. So suddenly we had to then scramble to figure out who are the other suppliers in Latin America and Middle East and so on and manage that. So, and these are all new suppliers, and then you had to make advance payment to them, which, as you all know, in all large corporations, making you have to set up the vendor, and making payments in such a fast, in such short notice is always a challenge. But then that's what procurement organizations had to do. So is that the new normal, where the procurement teams also have a an emergency channel of buying which is available and which becomes approved channel and not the the bypass that it is that we all have to resort to. Okay. Going forward, let's see what are the typical activities and where Infosys is offering help to its clients. Is in the immediate phase, and which is what we will be talking a little more in detail about, the dynamic risk assessment. So how do you know on a weekly basis which suppliers are available, how are they impacted, and of course currently it is about the availability of supply or the supplier itself. Going forward, it could be about you know, in once things become normal, hopefully soon, it could also be about what capacity they have, what kind of is, are they having any trouble on the financial front? Are they having any issues in terms of legal or any other capacity and similar issues, and or input material issues and so on? These are typically, so far, we have never monitored as procurement. We have never monitored on a dynamic basis, irrespective of whether there is some pandemic or some other disaster which is coming up in front of us. However, now it is also a lesson for us that we should be doing that. And this is a precursor to that kind of a service that we are offering, which is the Rapid Risk and Disruption Assessment Service. The other one is about, there are several procurement operations or several procurement teams which have got completely overwhelmed. They need some extra support, some extra hands which can help them with finding either new suppliers or even doing some category and sourcing management for them. So that also is something that Infosys is providing to several of its clients, and we are happy to extend that to other clients as well. Vendor payments prioritization, I talked about it earlier, and that is something that also we are providing, where we are able to quickly assess who are your suppliers whose payments are upcoming in the next 30, 60, 90 days, or 15, 30, 60, 90 days, and so on. And what should be the prioritization? So are they the prioritized group of vendors, like small and medium enterprise, or the large corporations, and so on? And or there is material that is urgently required and you need to pay in advance or pay in time for that, and so on. The payments prioritization, again, in a couple of the clients that we are providing the support for, cash flow is now being monitored at the CEO level, right? So it is a priority at that point of time. So that is something that, as I said, for crisis response and stabilization. Some of the other things that we are offering in terms of quick cash realization, or in terms of quick spend optimization. One could be a duplicate payments elimination. So there could be some vendors whom you have paid twice. It happens in all organizations, though it is small by percentage, but in several organizations, it runs into a couple of million dollars, if not more. And that could be one way to see that you have some immediate cash which is released from a working capital perspective. Other ways and means in terms of, say, for example, payment terms rationalization, what could be the quick and immediate payment terms rationalization that could be done? So those are some of the kind of services that we are offering. And from our transition to the new normal, so we need to look at in several organizations, there is, and most, a lot of organizations have realized because of the crisis, that the procurement data is the visibility in terms of what is the spend with that particular supplier, and what are the alternative suppliers, and so on. So the entire data foundation, if it is not very robust and cleansed and classified properly, that is creating a challenge for several organizations to manage the situation in this hour of crisis. So we are offering to build the procurement data foundation for our clients, and in terms of cleansing, classified, so that you have 90-95% of accuracy in your procurement data, and on a real-time basis. Not typically, this is done like, say, once in a couple of years, where you are cleansing classification, there are multiple duplicate vendors and things like that. So how can this be done on a near real-time basis, so that every month or at any point in time, you have the most accurate data regarding your spend, and as well as the suppliers, and you have full visibility to that. And you have the confidence that, yes, this is correct data, and you can take decisions based on that. As a part of, or as a consequence of the crisis, there is also a realization that several organizations were taking their own time to decide in terms of the automation journey to take. And there are a large number of activities which can be automated using the technology that is available. We have also done that for several of our clients, but we still find that in some of the client situations, they have not yet gone on that path, and there's still a lot of, say, manual intervention which is happening, manual activities which are happening in the in their procurement processes. So that is something that a lot of organizations are now deciding that they would want to go more aggressively. There is less dependence, especially for the operational activities, the transactional activities, you would want to automate it so that the dependence on manual and then where are those people, are they going to work from home and so on. So we are seeing a lot of interest in rapid automation using cognitive buying solutions and so on, right? So that is something also that we are offering to our clients. Even in terms of, as I said, you know, it's not only about data, but you have all the insights, the supply market intelligence, and you have everything all at one place so that you have a 360 degree view of what decisions to take in such kind of a crisis situation. Which suppliers are available, what is my spend, how many contracts are in place, are not in place, when are they expiring. Do you have a 360 degree view? And that is something that we have implemented for a couple of our clients, the category control tower, which gives that kind of a 360 degree view for category management and spend management. So these are some of the things that we are offering to our clients to come to the new normal, and we will be covering more in detail about them in subsequent webinar. Okay. So
yeah. So Chris, before we move ahead, I have the results from the poll. For some reason, I'm not sure why we were not able to display. Not sure why you were not able to see. So let me just call those out. So in terms of how severe has the impact of COVID-19 been? So the responses that we got was that 40% of the, this target audience today, they called it out as medium impact. And then 20%, called it out as high impact, that their operations have been affected and there is a high impact on that. And the same number is there for the low impact. For an extreme impact, there was nobody, polling for that option. And then for high and extreme for some locations and medium and low for other locations, the percentage was 5%. So which means that the group that is joined today, so the impact has been from medium to high.
Okay, so about 60-65% is basically there is some impact, and people are having their own ways in which they are trying to manage the situation. So let's see how we can support in the immediate term and in the next couple of days itself. Let's go into the detail of how we can do that.
So before we move ahead, I think we also wanted to understand, when it comes to assessing risks related to, securing your supplies, what have been your biggest challenges? And we are just trying to get this information to understand, whether the solution that we are offering, how relevant would that be for you? So, we'll request if you can, quickly, respond to that poll, so that we will be displaying the results in a while.
Yeah. So a quick, poll shouldn't take you more than 30 seconds to respond. Can we have the poll? Okay, so we'll come back with the results of that. And so basically, what is the service that we are talking about? So the rapid disruption and risk assessment service is to understand what is the impact of COVID-19 on your key suppliers. So you may have a set of key suppliers in different parts of the globe, and you would want to know, are they impacted, to what extent they are impacted, and this, as the situation is changing on a weekly basis, you would want to know that on a dynamic basis in terms of what is the situation as of today, which suppliers are available, which particular sites or plants they are able to support or not support, and things like that. right? And also to know, do your suppliers need any help from you to fulfill these supplies and so on, right? So that is the kind of the service that is there. We will get into the demo in terms of the detail. So there are questions, 10 questions that have been, we have compiled together based on our experience with the clients and what is currently running for some of our clients as well. So based on that experience, we have put together those 10 questions. However, they can be modified if based on what your organization's requirements are. It's a quick setup. So we just basically need a list of the suppliers that whom you would want to get this feedback and assessment for with the email ID and the name of the suppliers and so on. So that's all that is needed. If that cannot be provided to us, so with the existing clients, we already have like say an existing operation, so it's very easy for them to do that. But for new organizations which are going to engage us for this service at this point in time, if there is a challenge to provide us the list of suppliers to us separately, then we will send the link to you and you can email it out to the relevant vendors and they can take the survey. So it is a survey-based assessment and we will, as when we show you the demo, you will know how it works. It can be quickly set up within a couple of hours. So we just need to finalize what are the set of questions. Are you okay with them? Do you need some modifications? And then we either send the link to you or we get the email database or list of suppliers and we can send it out. For the suppliers, it will take less than 10 minutes to respond. So it's not so heavy on the suppliers. Typically, we have seen if it's a long questionnaire kind of thing and people don't respond or it is difficult for them to respond. But in this case, the questions are designed and the output format is also the way they are supposed to take the questionnaire is very simplified, as you would say. Post that on weekly or fortnightly basis, whenever at whatever periodicity you would like. The analytics and the report should be provided to you. You can either access them or we can send it to you as a PPT or PDF, whichever format you would like to have the reports. Right? In case there is, you need support for finding alternative suppliers for particular type of materials or services. For some of that, we should be able to support from using the supply market intelligence service that we provide for our clients. As I said earlier, we are already providing this for some of our existing clients. And in some cases, our clients have requested, while this is a basic service, which is like a quick assessment, and it gives you a high-level view of which locations and are going to be impacted, which sites are going to be impacted by some disruption of supplies or not. But there is more comprehensive risk service and solution that we are providing to some of our other clients, which we can talk about separately or offline. You can reach out to us and do that. Now, this survey, at this point in time, we are offering this complimentary till 30th of July to help clients to tide over the crisis and so that it is quick and easy to run. The moment there is some commercial involved, then it takes time for the organization to start. So hence, we wanted to remove that barrier. And we are offering it complimentary or free of cost till 30th of July. We will see if the, hopefully, the as all of us are hoping, the crisis would diminish and would be more manageable by that time. If that's the situation, then we can move to more comprehensive risk service. Alternatively, if the crisis continues and more organizations are needing this, we will take a call at that time. Okay. So as we said, if you have questions, we will take them up towards the end of the webinar. Meanwhile, we will go ahead and show you what is the way it works and the demo of the tool.
Yeah, Chris, before we move that, we also have the poll results ready, which have been already displayed for everyone to see. It's more or less an equitable kind of spread across all the options. So whether, we have 26% of people reporting that, it's very, we do not have any visibility on the disaster preparedness of the suppliers. Then it also 26% are also talking about, the bandwidth challenges to have a continuous engagement with the supplier. 22% participants have called out, there have been multiple scattered effects, but no holistic one. And another 19% talk about, there is a, challenge, from their perspective, that is the topmost challenge when it comes to identifying or securing alternative options for suppliers or looking at, alternative suppliers is concerned.
Okay. So I think this is in line with what we are seeing with the clients for whom we are providing the service as well. So if you have about 300, 500 or even 200 suppliers whom you need to monitor on a weekly basis as to are they impacted or not, it's a big challenge to do that. And if it is a global set of suppliers, then even more difficult to do that. Okay, let's go ahead with the demo. So basically, it's as I said, it's a very simple solution, though it is very useful. And there is the complexity is behind the solution. So while the usefulness, the usage is very simple, but the all the complexity in terms of etc. is done using the tool. So the users will basically get a link and which gives the narrative saying that this is why it is coming to you. And when they click on the link, they get to access the web-based survey. And this is the link, and the technology is provided by our technology partner, Solexar, who works extensively with Infosys in similar solutions across different areas. Okay. So right now I'm not seeing anything on the screen, Ria. So maybe you have to, your display is will not come up. Okay. So this is how the when the supplier clicks, they will see a screen like this, and there are options to do that in different languages as well. So they have to just enter the name of the company and who is the person who is responding to the survey, and their email as well. Okay, and then they can choose which country their manufacturing or service location is, there can be, if there is multiple, they can choose multiple as well for the purpose of the demo. So if they say they are impacted by COVID-19, then it leads to follow up. If they say that no, we are not impacted, then obviously the survey ends for them, right? So if they say yes, we are impacted, then it will lead to a set of follow-up questions to understand what is the extent of the impact. Yeah. So it will ask what percentage of full capacity you're running at, what is the level of confidence for critical activities, and in terms of we could structure this in terms of whether the availability of service personnel is there, will you be able to support our plant or premises from remotely, will you be able to provide the essential spares or services or any other consumables? So this is why this sample is from a for a manufacturing kind of supplier who's doing some manufacturing and providing you some parts and spares or services. But it can be structured differently if it is only service or and so on. Okay. And it we are also mentioning what is their level of confidence. What kind of, in terms of being able to come back to normal, what is the level of assistance or the criticality of assistance that is they need to be able to come back to and continue the supplies. Okay. Yeah, so whether they need help on logistics, on raw material, on health and safety related equipment, whether it is finances, so alternative source of supply assistance and things like that, right? So all this, what kind of assistance or support do they need? Is something that also that you will, or what is the challenge actually they are facing, is also something that you can get visibility on from the survey. And as you can see, it's designed very simple, in a very simple manner, which they can even respond from their mobile phone as well. They don't need to be logged into a laptop or computer for that. Okay. Also, you are able to get what is the expected time to recovery, so to full capacity or even to come back to any manufacturing. So that also is something that you can capture. And the level of confidence. So one is they are giving you a time frame, and also what is the confidence level. So it's a better way of being able to give you a more comprehensive assessment when we are able to measure the level of confidence as well. And you would also like to know that what steps they are taking to mitigate the delivery delays or to increase the safety stock and things like that. Are they adding some additional shifts and things like that? So all those, that visibility is something that you will have. And the advantage of using the tool that we are deploying for this is that there could be analysis even in terms of what is written in the comments section and so on. That could also be pulled out and analyzed as to what kind of responses people are taking for some of the mitigation steps. Right? So it's not just a survey like you would see in some of the other simple surveys that are available, but it is a complete assessment which gives you a comprehensive view, and as well as allows for comprehensive analysis of what is the problem, what suppliers are doing, what help do they need, and what kind of mitigation steps they are doing. So you have full visibility even from a basic assessment that is being done. And if the supplier is engaged with you for multiple locations, then that is also something that can be done here at site. Okay. So it's as simple as that. As we said, it takes less than 10 minutes for any supplier to do it, and that's how it is currently working as well for some of our clients who are availing of this service. Okay, so we will take any questions towards the end, as we said, and we'll continue so after the supplier survey, then the analytics and reporting, so you can get in terms of what capacity is available in which region, by city and so on, so multiple slice and dice are available. So it could be by a particular company itself. You could select, and the color itself tells you where do you have. You don't need to, by looking at the analysis itself, you will know what is, so it's basically a rag status. So you know what is red, amber, green. So you can straight away focus and focus your attention to whatever is red or amber, and green, you know, is on track, right? So that's how it's very intuitive in terms of the analysis that the tool is able to pull out. Okay. And it could be, and then which areas are at full capacity, in which geographies, who are the suppliers, all that drill down is also available. It could also be, by cities or plant locations that you were searching for. Okay. In terms of, you could also do the analysis in terms of confidence levels. So, for critical areas, what is the confidence level of your suppliers? That yes, they are very confident that they will be able to continue with the same level of capacity that output that they are currently doing, or they expect or dip. So that will also help you to be aware in advance as to where you need to look for alternative suppliers and so on. Okay, let's move on. Similarly, for if some suppliers are not able to supply, are they able to support remotely, and or they are able to send some service personnel from some other location or some other country, whether spares are available or not. So all that slice and dice, and with what level of confidence they are able to say that, is something that you will be able to see in the reports that are made available to you. Okay, let's go ahead. So again, then you will also know what kind of assistance, in which geography, where do suppliers need assistance. It could be that you are able to, you as a client organization are able to provide that assistance, or you may want some other partner to be pulled in to provide that assistance and so on. So it's not only about knowing which suppliers are up and running at that particular point in time and with what confidence they are able to say that, but also to know what assistance they will need and where you need to find solution. Okay, let's move on. Okay, I think we have covered this, so we can keep moving ahead. It could also be for specific areas, whether it is, as we said, whether it's finances or health and safety equipment, and so on, what assistance do they need? You will know specifically, and there could be targeted and focused attention given to providing that assistance to the supplier. Okay, let's move ahead. So, as I said, we can get started immediately. The letter of engagement, in terms of saying that yes, you are wanting Infosys to go ahead and do this for you. So that is something that we will need. And the survey setup, as I said, it is very simple. We have already, because of the groundwork and foundation that we have already done, so most of it is already set up. We just need to align with you and align the communication, etc., because suppliers need to communicated that they will be receiving this kind of communication, and they need to, what they need to do, what should be their response. And once that also, we have seen from our experience, it shouldn't take more than a day or two to solve that. Then the service can start right away. Yeah. So, and we have made it very simple and quick to start, primarily because that is what is the need of the hour. Okay. If the suppliers need any help, so Infosys will provide a help desk to if suppliers, they shouldn't need. It's a fairly straightforward. We have not seen any such need, but if they need, then, or they are having some challenge, the link is not working for them, that support will be provided. And with yourselves, we will have a weekly or fortnightly governance to just see that whether the service is working and are you getting the right inputs in terms of the decisions that you need to take and the analysis, is it to meet your requirements or not. Okay. Let's move ahead. So we've talked about one service in terms of how we can help you to stay in touch and have a view in terms of which suppliers are available, not available, and what help they need, and so on. But there could be other such services or help that you need. And we just wanted a quick view from you to see, do you need any other help beyond the one that we have talked about in the immediate term? And then we can come back to you about that as well. So again, a quick survey shouldn't take you more than 30 seconds to respond to it. So it could be about supplier risk-based segmentation. So it takes, so we need to segregate which suppliers are critical, which are not so critical, and so on. And that is one service that some of the organizations would need. It could be that you need a more comprehensive risk assessment for your critical suppliers, which goes beyond the basic service that we talked about. And that is also available and being availed of by a few of our clients. And there could be more category variations in the survey and the assessments. So that is also something that we will be happy to consider based on the individual discussions we will have. If there is anything beyond this as well, please feel free to write to us. The email ID is infiprocurement@infosys.com. So, and we will get back to you on how we can support you in that as well. Okay. So, Ria, if the survey is complete, we move forward.
Chris, we have another minute to go, and we still have some people. What we have now published, okay. We've just published the results. Let me just call it out.
Yeah. So, considering that we have another 11 minutes, so I just wanted to see that we give some time for people to ask questions, as we promised in the beginning of the webinar.
Sure, Chris. So we have the results already. So we have about 35% of the people, who are interested in terms of supplier risk-based segmentation as a service. And another 40% would want to know more about the wider supplier risk assessment service that we offer to our clients. And 12% have responded in terms of, enabling more category variations in the service. That's okay. The result. And people can actually, and I'm sure all of you can also see it on your screen.
Okay, so thanks for the feedback, and we will come back to you with maybe the next set of webinars would address some of these questions and what kind of service we can provide to meet the requirements. Okay, let's move ahead so that we'll just do a quick overview. As I talked about this earlier as well, there is this supply risk analysis hub that we have set up, which does some more of the detailing that we just talked about in terms of either the suppliers doing a composite risk scoring, a detailed risk analysis, including classification of suppliers or contracts, and so on. So there is a more detailed risk analysis, the risk assessment, and we will in the subsequent webinar, we will be covering this as well. And for some of you, we will respond individually as well what the requirements are. Okay. Let's move ahead. I talked about some of this. So, cash flow forecasting dashboard. So, that is something that we have implemented some of. As I said, in several organizations now, cash flow is a CEO level topic, and so we have deployed some of these dashboards to be able to let people have a better management of their cash flow. And payment terms rationalization and harmonization. So this can be a longer project as well. So in some organizations, we have done this over 3 to 6 months. Where possible, how do you standardize the payment terms and so on. Some of the other things we have discussed earlier, we duplicate invoice analytics and so on. Okay. So, and these we will be covering in the webinars that are upcoming, or you could write to us as well. Okay. So with that, we come to an end, and we will offer it up for questions.
Yeah, sure, Chris. So we have a few questions coming in. So we have, a question from John Tedesco. We've unmuted John. So John, if you could go ahead with your question.
I put in two questions, one of which you already responded, but it is available in the United States. The second was this offering until July 2020. Is only for the COVID specific risk assessment. Is that correct?
As of now, yes. But we can, if you have a requirement which is beyond that as well, we can extend it to beyond that as well.
Okay, thank you.
The current, most of the organizations currently are having a COVID-19 specific kind of requirement. But if you it to be more broad-based and extend it beyond July as well. So the service will be available beyond July as well. So so that, and it need not be COVID-19 specific beyond that.
Thank you, Chris.
Okay.
Okay, do we have any more questions? I don't see any more hand raises. So please raise your hands, or you could send in your questions through chat. We'll be able to take them. So while we are waiting to do that, I just also wanted to, tell you that, post, you also have an opportunity to write to us at info@infosys.com if you have any questions. We will also have a recording as well as, the presentation deck available for a download in the next 1 or 2 days. So, you can get that further information from there as well. So let me just, I think we have Balaji asking a question. So Balaji, you've been unmuted. Please go ahead and ask the question.
Hi, Chris. My question is particularly in the area of contingent labor. Do you have any interactions with your clients wherein contingent labor or contractor as a major category, how have they basically managed that? Because neither the supplier nor the company are accustomed to the new ways of working, because due to the culture or due to the technology constraints or the landscape that they have. So do you have any thoughts on how this company is managing this area of the spend?
Yeah, so in one instance we have where the contractor or say the prime contractor has forwarded the survey to all the individuals who are working as a subcontractor to the main organization, right? And they are responding actually on once in 2 or 3 days intervals, in terms of because they have like a few hundred people who are on contract, and how do you know who's available, who's not available, and if unfortunately if anybody of them is not available due to being affected and so on, or because of some other reason, personal or because of the situation in that particular region, and how to know that. So this can be extended to contractors or contingent labor at an individual level as well. It's just the email that needs to go to them, but that is something also that organizations are doing. So you could look at it from that perspective as well. So it need not only be suppliers of materials and services only. It could be individuals who are working as subcontractors and in a way who are basically sub-suppliers to the main primary contingent labor supplier.
Okay. We have a hand raised by James Shaw. James, you have been unmuted. Please, can you speak up and ask your question?
Sure, thank you. Thanks. Hi, Chris. Just a quick question on the assessment. You mentioned that there were multiple languages. How many languages will there be? And is Chinese one of them?
Yeah, so I would let Pedar, who is our Solexar partner, to answer that. There are multiple languages available. And Chinese is also available, but I would let Peder answer that. Peder, can you unmute Peder, please? So anyway, to answer your question, James, yes, Chinese is one of the questions.
We also have a question from Bhavna, Bhavna Uttam Chandani. And the question is, will this assessment cover tier two suppliers also?
Yes, so it can cover tier two suppliers as well. So as I said, it is up to the client organization to define who are the suppliers. It could be tier one, it could be tier two suppliers, or as in the case, the question which was asked earlier, that if you have contingent labor and you want to find out directly from the subcontracted professionals, whether they are available, not available, and so on. So it could be extended to tier two, tier three suppliers as well.
Okay. Bhavna, does that answer? I hope that answers your question. If you have a follow-up question, you can, send it to me so that we, send it to us so that we can take it up. We just have a last minute remaining. So we have Nick Finia who wants to ask a question. So Nick, you've been unmuted. Please, can you go ahead and ask your question?
Yeah, Chris, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Thank you. So I was just asking, can you give us an idea about the fee structure beyond the, I guess, free service time, which is in July?
I don't have a ready fee structure because we haven't worked that out, but we will keep it quite nominal beyond that as well, because for the basic assessment, it will be very nominal. And we have seen is that most clients would like more comprehensive risk assessment rather than just a basic one. So the pricing would be for what typically people are asking is the price for the comprehensive one. The basic one, as we have already said, is free for now, but we'll come back to you on the pricing 31st July. But it'll be very nominal. It will not be something which will be a deterrent to anyone get beyond.
Okay, thank you, Chris.
Yeah, you're welcome. Okay, so if there is no other question, Ria?
No, we do not have any further questions. So I think we can, you know, go ahead and close the session for today. Also, you know, if you have any questions, I'll request if you can write in to us at infiprocurement@infosys.com. And you would also have, you know, as I mentioned, you will also have a downloadable link for the presentation and the recording for this webinar up in next to 1 or 2 days. We will also be sending you a communication to that. As you close, I have a request. If you can also, there will be a survey that will, you know, pop up on your screen, which will help us, you know, understand whether this webinar was of, you know, use to you, and if there is a way that we can make it better. So I'll request if you can share, you know, your feedback on the survey as well. So I think we're done, Chris.
Thank you, everyone, for joining, and hopefully it was useful. And please stay safe. Along with your families and near and dear ones. And hopefully for all of us, we will be out of this crisis soon. Thank you very much once again for joining the session today. Thank you, bye-bye.